Olimar versus Palutena. Both of these guys really solid characters as well. I actually use Palutena sometimes, not really one of my mains, I'd say, but Kin versus Classy, Polian versus. No, Polian just fought Ayoku. This is Kin versus Classy, Palutena versus Olimar. Now, Palutena trying to stay on top, going for that up smash, not gonna get it. And that's what makes Olimar so good. His grab can do some pretty nasty combos. Kin trying to pressure once again with that big pole of light. A nice downer to cover the landing, killing those Pikmins with the big chicken wings. And what makes Olimar really good is exactly that. He hits hard. He can just grab you, down throw you, and forward air, and that's going to be about 30% damage. And then once he gets those purple Pikmin, he's going to be hitting quite bad. He's going to be getting. Oh, look at that. He got a kill from an op throw at like 120 something, was that? That is intense. Kin with a nice upper, going for another one, not gonna get it. Classy being able to dodge right through it. The red Pikmin going to be putting in the damage. Ooh, nice! That was a very solid get off me option. And almost getting it. If he would have connected that upper, that would have probably been it. Trying to pressure once again with the explosive flame. I've heard a lot of people call it a lot of different things, but it is explosive flame. She actually says it, so it still amazes me how some people get that wrong. But now Kin is going to be taking 70% damage already. She needs to get this KO quickly. Trying to go for the up smash, not gonna work. Another one, and it's still not gonna work. 86%, a solid hit from the right Pikmin could do the trick right now. What the hell? I call it the fireball. Yeah, that makes sense too. Nice recovery by Kin. She went as low as possible and waited for the last second until they do the up B. She's trying to get it with the explosive flame, but as long as that Olimar stays in close, that explosive flame is not going to be killing. She needs to try to find. What you usually want to try to do is that once your opponent is at a certain percent, at Olimar didn't stay close, he got explosive flame. What you usually want to try to do is that when your opponent is at high percents, instead of going for smash reads, you can try to kill them with a solid hit that doesn't come out that slow. Ooh, the Pikmin toss, catching Kin off guard, off the stage. Gen Sox, thank you for that host. Kin needs to be trying to make the comeback here. That dash attack gonna be killing some Pikmin, but a grab, and look at that, grab to 42%. She wasn't a zero, but that still hurt. Another good explosive flame. Kin is not giving up just yet. She gets another grab. That's not going to combo anymore. The recovery is going to get her up there quick enough. But she's still taking damage from the Pikmins. What Kin should be trying to go here, instead of those smashes, Kin should be trying to get a quicker move in there. Palutena can kill with her back aerial. Her back air is actually this shield hit that is really good. A counter might work as well, but it's a lot more risky than going for the back air. Kin still not out, 107%, but she could still get. Oh, she gets hit by that flame. A nice dodge, and I think she can still make it back. Yes, that was a nice recovery from Kin. And going for the explosive flame, not gonna be enough with that smash. But, oh, she forgot. She got too much lag from the explosive flame. Otherwise, she could have just jumped and upbeat and she would have been okay. But nice, solid gameplay by Classy right here. Kin not doing bad herself. And remember, guys, this is best of three. So we're still getting one more. And two more if Kin can take game two. If Kin can some. Yeah, exactly, Ayoku. If Palutena can get those back airs close to the ground, they're great for pressure. He's so good at attaching the Pikmin. That's what I'm noticing, spacing. He's getting a lot of damage just by throwing the Pikmin and have them do the work. He doesn't have to do anything. He just throw the Pikmin and they're going to be putting in the damage. So here we go, game two. And this is same characters. Nice. The chicken wings putting in the work. And she goes, ideally, usually with most characters, not with everyone, but with most characters, you want to go for down throws at low percents, because most down throws will combo into either a forward air or a back air if you're quick enough. And just like that, we are seeing the percentages are even. Palutena getting another solid hit in. Under pressure with explosive flame, not gonna get it. But we have, just like we said, we have a yellow Pikmin doing some damage there. Still, this is very even. A forwarder gonna get Palutena off the stage, and oh, she says, okay, you can toss that white Pikmin at him, at me. I'm just gonna explosive flame you. But Kin is actually, she made this pretty much even. We saw a lot more dominant play from Classy that first game. Kin should still be able to make it back. Ah, she went too low. She went too low, and Classy taking the first stock. That Olimar is nice. That dash attack. He needs to try to land safely. And he does. You see, this is something that's very important. A lot of people, when they're up in the air, they tend to go for either a jump or a dodge straight away. And if you notice, what Classy is doing right here is that... Oh no, Kin. The teleport and the homie stock by Classy. That is a true act of kindness right there. GG's to Classy for that. But what the problem is that most people just go for an escape option straight away. They either jump or they just try to do something to get out. And Kin is saying, I've had enough. GG's both of you. But that was a nice match as well. That first stock was actually great. It was dead even up until Classy got the kill.